Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to ask, do you need a degree to be a software developer? I was having a chat with someone on Skype the other day, and he was asking, and we're talking about different things, app related and stuff like that, and then he was asking me questions about what he should do with his future. Basically, he was asking me whether or not he should go to university and get a computer science degree because he was really young. He got out of high school and he was working at different places for the last few years. He was wondering whether or not he should go back to university and get a computer science degree. And I really didn't want to answer that question. He was asking me what he should do, and I said, I really can't. I'm more of an app developer than, you know, like a guidance counselor or anything like that. I don't feel comfortable saying that. And besides, I had to tell him, like, I don't have a computer science degree, right? I have a degree, but it's not in computer science, right? So basically, and I know I may have told you guys this already before, my degree is in history. I majored in history with a psychology minor. So, and as you can guess, you know, you get a degree like that, and from Central Missouri State University. So I moved all over the place while I was getting my degree, kept transferring my credits because, yeah, I had gotten out of the Army and my wife was still in the Air Force. So, you know, she was still moving around. So I was going, you know, going with, right, and getting little jobs here and there. And so, but when I finally finished, it was from Missouri. So I graduated from Central Missouri State University with a history degree and a minor in psychology. And as you can guess, the employers were just banging down the door, right? I had to beat them up with a stick. Everyone wanted to employ me. So, you know, so obviously nobody wanted to hire me. And there was, yeah, I found such a hard time finding a job, mostly because as soon as I got that degree, I moved to the UK. So I moved to the UK. Right, and I have a degree in history, mainly American history, to teach history, which the certification didn't transfer over. I had no money, I needed a job, and I just started applying everywhere. And I've told this story before, how, you know, I somehow managed to land into an IT job, which was way over my head, and I just had to read everything I could and get up to speed with things as fast as I could, and try, and basically it was trying not to lose that first job, because I was, yeah, I felt like for a while there that I was just, you know, I was hanging on the edge, because they started to think maybe we shouldn't have hired someone with so little experience. But I was like, no, I wasn't gonna let that happen. So I read as much as I could. I got up, you know, up to speed as fast as I could. And the thing about technology is that wherever you get on, you can become the expert in that thing, right? You're not gonna know everything in the past, but nobody does. Like, I, you know, nobody needs skills in COBOL at the moment, but they might need JavaScript or Node.js. You know, nobody needs VB5 at the moment, but they might need something else, you know, whatever the current thing is. So, you know, somebody with 30 years experience is someone with 2 years experience or 5 years experience or 6 months experience. It doesn't matter. It's more, you know, how much hands-on you get with the technology that you're using, right? So for me, I've never placed a lot of value in the computer science degree, mainly because I don't have one, right? And I've worked with people before who have argued with me about this because they've had that degree, right? And they've gone through and they've done all that. I mean, I have a degree, but it just wasn't related, right? And I was talking to somebody else about changing careers, and I was saying, you know, it just, nobody has ever asked me about my education, about my degree when I go for a job, right? It's on the CV, so maybe they use it to weed stuff out, but, you know, I'm sure the history thing's not gonna really make a big difference, right? And, you know, so maybe they use it to weed out, but nobody's ever asked about my jobs. That first job was hard to get. My first technology job was difficult to get, right? And I'm still surprised I got it now. But after that, everything else was based on my experience and my portfolio after that. So, you know, when I was talking to this guy, I was saying, you know what, I would do, you know, in this day and age, I would focus more on your portfolio. If you can get a job in technology now, do it. If you want to be an app developer, a professional app developer, and you can get a job as an app developer and doing your own apps on the side, that would be fantastic. If you can't, maybe you have to go, you know, a bit lower down. Maybe you become a software engineer or like a software QA type person, or work in a place that does that kind of stuff, and then work your way up the ranks. But if you know what you want to do, because I didn't know what I wanted to do when I got out of high school and I went into the Army, I didn't know what I wanted to do. When I got out of the Army and went into university, I wanted to be a journalist, and then I changed my mind because I thought it would be easier to get a job with a history degree than with a journalism degree. Dude, I don't know what I was thinking. I thought it would be easier to get a, because you see history teachers all the time. I thought I could get a job doing that, but it'd be harder to get a job as a journalist. So I talked my way out of it. You know, my low self-confidence just pushed me out of the way, right? So you know, if I always base on this, right? If I had two people come to me for a job as, say, like an app developer or anything in technology, and I have one guy who just got out of university with a really, you know, really nice university and, you know, really high grades. I got another guy who comes to me and he's got a whole portfolio of apps, and he says maybe he worked at a few different technology firms. I'll go with that guy, or a guy who says, you know, he's blogged about it, he's been active in the industry, all that kind of stuff. I'd go with that guy. Another thing I like to look at is somebody who's worked in a team, right? Because I'm a firm believer that you get better as a developer when you work with other developers. I could think about in my career, there's certain cases where I think before working with this person and after working with this person. I said before working with Shola, after working with Shola. Before working with Craig, after working with Craig. Before working with Mark, after working with Mark. Because they made me better developers because they were really passionate about what they did. And it wasn't so much that their code was great, although it was, right? But it was more like it made me better because I wanted to improve what I was doing because I didn't want to embarrass myself around them. So when I'm looking for someone as a developer, I'm looking for someone who's, if it's someone with no experience at all, I would want somebody who is passionate about the industry, somebody who's built up that portfolio, even though nobody's told them to, even though, you know, I think the thing that I hate the most when I'm interviewing someone, when I'm hiring someone, is if I ask about something and they say, I really wanted to do that, but my boss wouldn't let me, right? And I'll say, well, you know what? You could have done it anyway, right? Development tools are cheap, you know, I can remember wanting to buy Visual Basic 5, right? And it was like £1,000 to get a license for, or £600 or something like that, which was way outside my budget. So I would try to stay late after work so I could work on this kind of stuff on my own, right? And now everything is free, and you know, there's no excuse to not know this kind of stuff. So anyway, that's just my opinion. What do you guys think? Do you disagree with that? Do you think there's value in a computer science degree in this day and age? Do you think there's any value in any degree at all? So anyway, that's just what I think. You know, I could be wrong. Yeah, and that's one of the reasons why I didn't want to give the advice on it, because I don't want to be responsible for dissuading someone from doing something that could maybe benefit them in the future. But for me, it's really had no benefit. So anyway, that's it for today. I'll talk to you tomorrow.